The next step is to define our existing ground levels. To do this, we make sure our existing tab is selected, and then we click on the plus button to add a new feature surface. Now in these controls, we define all of the elevation features we have available for the surface. We have contours in our CAD file, so we will select the Contours tab and then click on this button to load the contours from a file. So I click on my CAD file, so now I have this pop-up with the following options, and there are two things we have to do here. The first is to select the layers that contain the data we want to load and turn off all the others that we don't want. So I'm going to click on the existing contours and I am going to deselect the proposed contours. Now I'm going to give you a tip here, because most of the time you have way more layers to deselect. So if you click on Ctrl plus A, you select all the layers and then you can load them all, or you can deselect all and then choose the one you want to load. And this is very useful because most of the time you need to load more than one and you have to unselect more than these six layers. Now the second thing I want you to pay attention when you use this is the units. And you should always check that they are set correctly here, because most users are confused by this control because they assume that a CAD file defines its units. Surprisingly, this isn't the case. The CAD file just stores numbers and doesn't tell us whether those numbers are in meters, millimeters, feet or inches. Now, Kubla Cubed will guess the most likely units, but you need to check that this is correct, or everything will load into the wrong position and scale. Now, once we have chosen these two, we can click OK, and then the contours will be loaded in the software. Now that we have all our contours defined, we need to define an outline for the site. To start this, we click on the Outlines tab. Now, you often end up drawing site outlines on the screen, even if you're working with CAD files. This is because CAD files often seem to have gaps in the outlines and sometimes other issues. Since outlines typically don't take long to draw, you often revert to the on-screen method, although you can load them from CAD if you have them. Now, I will demonstrate drawing on the screen by clicking on this button and then choosing Draw, and then extrapolate. And then I will just click on each point of the perimeter. I zoom in to be more precise. And as always, I can finish either by right-clicking or by pressing Enter. Now the extrapolate option we just selected tells the software to take the outline levels from the content inside it, which is the contour lines in this case. This option is almost always used for existing outlines. So now I'm happy I have everything, and I will click OK. And the software will define the existing levels. So this is my surface.